Three Kids. It's Miss Sarah. It's so good to see you. I'm glad that you're here for our lesson today. Let's start out by praying together. Let's close our eyes and bow our heads and talk to God. Dear God, thank you so much for this time that we have to learn from your word. Please teach us what you want us to know and help us to grow in our relationship with you because of the time that we are spending today. In Jesus' name, amen. Enjoy the lesson.
Jesus stood before Pilate, the governor. Pilate asked him, "Are you the king of the Jews?" Jesus answered, "Yes, that's right." Then the religious leaders made accusations against Jesus. But Jesus did not say anything. Pilate was surprised that Jesus was silent. Every year at Passover, the governor would free a prisoner, whichever prisoner the people chose. At that time, there was a prisoner named Barabbas, who was very dangerous. So Pilate asked the crowd, "Who do you want me to set free? Barabbas or Jesus, who is called the Messiah?"
The crowd answered, "Barabbas." Pilate asked, "Then what should I do with Jesus, who is called the Messiah?" The crowd answered, "Crucify him." Pilate asked, "Why? What has he done wrong?" But the crowd kept shouting, "Crucify him." Pilate's soldiers took Jesus to the governor's palace and gathered around him. They took off his clothes and put a scarlet robe on him.
They made a crown of thorns and put it on his head. Then they hit Jesus and mocked him. "Hail, King of the Jews," they said. The soldiers nailed Jesus to a cross. Then they cast lots to decide who would get his clothes. They put a sign above his head that said, "This is Jesus, the King of the Jews." Two criminals were crucified next to him. As Jesus was on the cross, people mocked him. "He saved others, but he cannot save himself," they said.
From noon until 3 in the afternoon, darkness covered the land. Then Jesus cried out, my God, why have you forsaken me?" Jesus shouted again with a loud voice, "It is finished." Then Jesus died. Suddenly, the curtain in the temple sanctuary split in two from top to bottom, and there was an earthquake. One of the men near the cross said, "This man really was God's son." Jesus was buried in a rich man's tomb cut into a rock. A stone was sealed in front of the tomb, and Roman soldiers stood guard so that no one could steal Jesus' body.
We deserve to die because of our sin, but God loves us and kept his promise to send a Savior. Jesus never sinned, but he died in our place. He was the blood sacrifice made once and for all the forgiveness of sin. Jesus rose from the dead on the third day, and those who trust in him have forgiveness and eternal life.
Hello, I'm Mark Busby. I'm the team leader for the International Mission Board in Tokyo, Japan. This past year, we had an incredible time of partnering with people around the world for the opportunity afforded to us through the 2020 Tokyo Olympics. It was an incredible time of ministry together with local Japanese churches, international churches that are in the city already, and with churches around the world that came to Tokyo specifically to minister to the people who come to the Olympics and to minister to the Japanese churches and the people that are there. It was an incredible time of ministry. From this point on, we plan to work with these churches and these newly formed partnerships to follow up on the ministry that was laid with the Olympics and the focus that we had with the Olympics. We thank you for your prayers. We thank you for your participation. We thank you for your giving that you gave in order to make that great opportunity happen. I'm looking forward to partnering with you and others to continue the work in Tokyo, Japan.
Goodbye to goodbyes. In the little town of Bethany, there lived a man named Lazarus. He had two sisters, Mary and Martha. Martha loved to throw a party. Mary loved to sit and listen. Lazarus loved his two sisters, and they were all friends with a man named Jesus. But one day, Lazarus got sick. He went to bed sick, and he woke up sick. Martha and Mary looked after him, but Lazarus got worse and worse. "I know," said Martha. "I will tell our friend Jesus. He can help." Martha thought about all Jesus had done. He made the blind people see. He made the deaf people hear. He made people who had been sick walk, jump, run, and leap for joy. He could make Lazarus well. So she and Mary sent a message to Jesus. "Lord Jesus, our brother Lazarus, the friend that you love, is sick. Come quickly." It took 2 days for Martha's message to reach Jesus. And when Jesus heard his friend was very, very sick, he did nothing. Did nothing? That's right. He didn't ride the first donkey to Bethany. He didn't run until his side hurt. For 2 whole days, he stayed right where he was. Why? Jesus told his disciples, "Our friend Lazarus is very sick. But this illness won't end with Lazarus being dead. We won't have to say goodbye forever. I have a plan." Phew, Jesus had a plan. But what was it? Then at last, Jesus and his disciples headed to Bethany. "Our friend Lazarus has fallen asleep," Jesus announced, "but I'm on my way to wake him up." The disciples looked at each other. Did they hear him right? Lazarus was sleeping? Couldn't Mary and Martha wake him up? Jesus knew their questions. He looked at them and said, "Lazarus has died." Dead? How could this be? Didn't Jesus say that Lazarus would not die? Didn't he say they wouldn't have to say goodbye forever? What happened to his plan? Every step to Bethany felt heavier and heavier. Their hearts sank deeper and deeper. They were sad their friend had died. They didn't even get to say goodbye. 4 days after Lazarus had died, Jesus and his disciples finally arrived. Martha came running to meet them. Her face was sad. Her eyes were red. "Lord," she gasped, "if only you had been here, Lazarus would not have died. But I know nothing is impossible with you, even after someone's died and we've said our forever goodbyes." "You're right, Martha," Jesus said. "There is a day coming when we will say goodbye to saying goodbyes forever. Do you believe that?" Martha nodded. "Yes, I believe in you, Jesus. I know you are the Son of God, and I know you always do what you promise. You will end all our goodbyes forever." Martha went and fetched Mary. Mary was so sad. The brother she loved was gone. She would never hug him again. She would never eat with him again. She would never see his face again. Jesus saw her tears, and then it happened. His heart broke. He knew what he was about to do. He knew Lazarus's goodbye wasn't forever, but his heart broke for his friends. When they reached Lazarus's tomb, Jesus cried too. They cried, and cried and cried because they'd had to say a forever goodbye. But then Jesus stopped crying and said, "Take away the stone." Martha told him there might be a horrible smell. Jesus said, "You need to believe me." So they took away the stone. Then he yelled like a mighty lion's roar, "Lazarus, come out!" And he did. Jesus kept his word. Lazarus being sick didn't end with him being dead. It ended with him alive, even after he had died, after they'd had to say goodbye. Mary, Martha, Lazarus, and Jesus were together again. Martha threw a party. Mary laughed and listened. Lazarus was glad to be alive. But then the time came for Jesus to say goodbye. He hugged the friends that he loved and said, "Goodbye for now, but not forever." Jesus had to go to Jerusalem, where he would be the one to say goodbye and die, and then, like Lazarus, walk out of a tomb alive. And after that, Jesus said goodbye again, because he was going back to heaven. It was sad for Jesus's friends to say goodbye, but they would see him again in the land that lay after their dying, in the land where there are no more goodbyes, not ever. Well, we all have to say goodbye sometimes. Some of them are short goodbyes. Some are long. Sometimes a friend of Jesus who we love gets sick and we're sad. Sometimes, because they die, we have to say goodbye. It feels like a forever goodbye. Jesus knows it is sad to say goodbye. So Jesus came to end goodbyes. And one day, Jesus and all his friends will say goodbye to goodbyes forever.
Hi there, I'm Pastor Brian, and it's time for Questions from Kids. Nora from Amarillo, Texas asks,
"If salvation is a gift, why does God want us to do good things?"
That is a fantastic question. Another really important question. I love the questions you kids ask. So here's the thing we have to understand. We don't do good things to be saved. Let's be real clear about that, because the Bible is really clear about that, and it's really important. We can't do enough good things to earn God's forgiveness or his acceptance. That's not how the gospel works. We know the gospel is all about God's grace to us, that he forgives us based on what Jesus has done, his good works, not our works. And so when we think about salvation, we understand that clearly. But then the question is, well, what does it look like to be saved? What does it look like to live a life in light of God's salvation? And this is where good works do come into focus. And the Bible does tell us that we are created to do good works in Jesus. So what are they about? Again, they're not about saving us or even maintaining our salvation. It's not like God saying, "All right, well, Brian's saved now, but he has to do enough good things to keep saved." No, that's not the case. Here's the reality. We do good things because we want to make much of Jesus. We do them in light of what God has done for us. We do them out of gratitude, out of love, because of how good God is. And we want others to see that God is true and he makes a difference in our lives, that salvation means something, not just in heaven one day far off, but right now. It means something day by day. That is why we do good things. We do them to brag on God, to show how good he is to the world around us. So here's a question back for you. How can doing good things point others to Jesus?
Well, that's it for our lesson today. Let's pray together before we end our time. Let's close our eyes and bow our heads and talk to God. Dear God, thank you so much for this lesson. Please help us to remember the things that you want us to know and to live differently this week because we follow you. In Jesus' name, amen. Have a good week.
Thank you.